Now we'll discuss about kinetic energy of a rigid body in rotation. As we already know that for a particle of mass m, if it moves at a speed v, its kinetic energy we can write as half m v squared, that is the energy associated with the motion of the particle. Similarly, if we talk about a rigid body, which is pivoted about a given axis of rotation and is rotating at an angular speed omega. Obviously, in this situation, different particles are moving at different speeds due to its rotational motion. So, the whole body must have some associated kinetic energy with it. And this energy we call kinetic energy of the body in rotational motion. To calculate this kinetic energy, we first consider an elemental mass dm in the body at a distance x from the axis of rotation. If the body is rotating at an angular speed omega, this dm will be revolving in a circular path with a tangential linear speed that is given as x omega. As in case of rotation, all particles will have same angular speed, but due to different distances, it will have different linear speeds. So here we can find kinetic energy of dm is, this kinetic energy dk can be given as half dm multiplied by x omega whole square. Or on simplifying, we'll get it half dm x square omega square. So, we can write total kinetic energy of a rotating body is, it can be given as total kinetic energy is equals to integration of dk, that will be equals to integration of half dm x square omega square. As we know, for all particles of body, omega will be a constant. This half and omega square can be taken out of the sign of integration. So, it is half omega square integration of dm x square, which we know this is the moment of inertia of body, which we already studied. So, we can write the kinetic energy of body as half I omega square. This is the total kinetic energy associated with the rotational motion of the body. Similar to the situation we have studied, let's find out the kinetic energy of a rotating body about moving axis of rotation. To analyze the situation, if we consider a thin uniform rod, which is of mass m and length l, and say rod is rotating about its center at an angular speed omega, and center is moving translationally at a speed vc. In this situation, the center of mass of rod will move in a straight line, and the rod would be rotating about its center at some angular speed. So here we can state the rod will be having two different kinetic energies in it. One is due to the rotation about center. So total kinetic energy will be the kinetic energy of rotation about its center plus the kinetic energy due to translatory motion of center of mass, that is half mvc square, which can be written as translational kinetic energy. And this rotational kinetic energy about center we can write as half I omega square. So, total energy will be half I omega square plus half mvc square. This is the expression we use for total kinetic energy of a body which is moving translationally as well as rotating about its center of mass. Be careful that the expression is valid only if the body is rotating about its center of mass, and here vc is the velocity of center of mass of body. In this problem, we are given a wheel of moment of inertia I and a radius r, which is free to rotate about the horizontal axis passing through its center O. And it is saying an ideal string is wrapped on it and attached to a small mass m. And it is saying if the system is released, we are acquiring the speed of mass m after falling through a distance h. Initially, it was released from rest, and when it will fall by a distance h, we are required to find the speed with which it is moving. Say the speed is v. So, if the speed of all the particles on a string attached to it is v, we can say that the wheel will rotate at an angular speed omega, which can be written as v by r, because the tangential speed of all particles on the surface of wheel will be r omega if it is rotating at angular speed omega. So, in this situation, we can easily handle the situation by using work energy theorem. Like if we use work energy theorem, we can analyze that initial kinetic energy of system was zero, and the only force which is doing work in the situation is gravity, or the weight acting on the block of mass small m. So, it can be written as plus small mg into h, if h is the height to which it has fallen, must be equal to the final kinetic energy, which can be given as the sum of kinetic energies of the block as well as that of the wheel. The block will be having a kinetic energy half mv square, plus the kinetic energy of wheel we can write as half I omega square. Omega we can write as v by r, so it is v square by r square. Now, in this situation, on simplifying, we'll get the speed as root of 2 mgh r square by I plus mr square. That is the answer to this problem. Quite a simple analysis. We also studied earlier in the chapter of work energy part that when are in situations we are required to find some speed of moving bodies, it is advisable to use work energy theorem. The same we are using here. The only difference is we need to account for rotational kinetic energy of an object which is rotating in the system along with the other translationally moving objects.